Hello everyone, today we're going to talk about vector indices. Why do we need vector indices? A basic understanding of how they work, how to add more documents after we already built one. And then we want to use Langchain with Hugging Face embeddings and ChatGPT to build a retrieval engine. And just for fun at the end, we're also going to build a Telegram chatbot. Why do we need vector indices? Because we want to be able to add documents and search them and combine knowledge from the documents to answer some questions. And sometimes the knowledge to answer a question is scattered in the document, so you don't have the specific answer to your question on one side. You have to combine the knowledge from page 2 and page 10, page 30, and that's where the vector index is going to help. We're going to load up the documents and split them in different chunk sizes. In our case, we're going to do 1000. And here in the picture, you can see the content are going to be the PDF files, which are split up. They will be put through the embedding model. And the vector embeddings are going to be stored in the vector index. Here's vector database. The difference is just the vector database provides more management capabilities of the embeddings and many more advantages. For example, real-time updates with the poor vector index. If you want to add another document, you have to load the index, add the documents, and save it again. With the managed database, for example, you would have your database running as a Docker file. You would connect your application to the Docker file to retrieve information. Also, you could connect to the Docker file and add new documents simultaneously. Right now, we just want a simple demonstration. We're going to load 50 PDF files, and there's a vector index is going to be sufficient here. And if you're going to query the index, the query is also going to be encoded with the same embedding model our documents got encoded with, and then we can perform a similarity search and return the most similar documents to our query. And one document is one chunk. Okay, let's build it. We're going to use the Facebook AI similarity search index. The requirements we're going to need, you can also use Phi's CPU. It's also pretty fast. I already tested it. The .env file for the OpenAI key. First, we make a file to create the index, then we have to make a retrieval file and also one file for the Telegram chatbot. The requirements here, we want to load the documents here with the PyPDF loader. You could also use the PyPDF directory loader to directly load the whole directory, but I want to load the documents one by one so we can use the TQDM library to display the progress. We're going to use the load and split method, which takes a text splitter. There will be a default one if you go to text splitter, to the base text splitter. It will have a chunk size of 4000, which is a little bit too much since we're using ChatGPT. The base model, which just has a 4k context size. So in this case, with the base settings, one chunk, one document would already fill the whole content size. Therefore, we are going to make it a little bit smaller, and therefore we need to define a text splitter.
Okay, let's find load documents, directory, the text splitter, so it be the recursive text splitter, the chunk size of 1000, and chunk overlap of say 8.
The overlap, so each chunk will have an overlap with the previous chunk, so that the model understands that these documents that are retrieved in a row belong together. We want to save the documents in a list for item path in blob. I defined the documents in a data directory. There are 50 PDF files. In my case, these are all books, PDF books. Directory plus star.pdf. So every PDF file in directory is going to be loaded and it's going to ignore every other file.
Loader is going to be the PyPDF loader from the item path documents.extend loader load and split. And we want to add a text splitter at the end, return the documents.
Ah, also, I forgot we want to wrap it in TQDM. So as I told you, we can see the progress bar. Let's get the Hugging Face embeddings.
Hugging Face embeddings.
Let's just take these embeddings. I think I have it actually from a Langchain website, from tutorial there. I'm going to make it run on my GPU. You can make it on a CPU. Okay, I just realized I made a little mistake considering the embeddings. It was intended to be used for document chunks of the size 256. This means that our recursive character text splitter, we have to set the chunk size to 256. Don't be confused by how this looks. I changed the code a little bit, so this is how it's going to look in the GitHub repository if you want to download it. I added a config file, so we have to use the chunk size of 256 here because it will truncate every token that's over 256. So all the information that's longer is lost. And just to give you an idea how the character text splitter is working, it's taking 256 tokens and it's looking at a point where it can split the chunks. Let's say a split point would be dot. Therefore, every chunk is maximum 256 tokens long, and it might be smaller. And as you can see here, there are cases where it's very small. Therefore, it would be better to actually use an embedding model which can handle larger chunk sizes. So why are we using this model here? Well, we can look at the leaderboard. The model we are using is at place 26. I'm going to provide you the link. It's pretty small, but if we look at the paper here, considering the speed, it's very fast. And for presentation purposes here, we want a very fast model. So I tried it with another model, the E5 Large V2, and it took way, way longer to create the index, to embed the chunks. If you're making this for a client, I would just use the model from OpenAI. It has a sequence length of 8,000, so you can use really large chunk sizes. Okay, in the vector database, going to be the files from documents, embedding function. After it's created, we also want to save it b.save local place db. And the index is going to be my books. You can define multiple index names in the same vector store. You can think about it as tables in an SQL database. And we also want to confirm that it's working. Search on the query principles. So I'm going to run it in a Docker file with the NVIDIA runtime so it can work with the GPU. And here I'm just connecting this directory inside the Docker. I'm just going to use the latest PyTorch Docker file. Install the requirements as always. And let's run the create index file. Let's see if there will be an error. Okay, here we can see the TQDM progress bar. It's going to take a little bit. In the meanwhile, we can create the next Python file. From Langchain chains retrieval QA, lot.env. Make sure you have added the key in the .env file. Let's just copy the embedding function.
Database local and embedding are the embedding function. Question and answer model is going to be the retrieval QA from LM. LM will be the chat open AI.
Obviously, need to import it as well.
And we need to add the retriever, db.s retriever.
And here we got our results returned from the similarity search. For retrieval Q&A, these documents are going to be sent to the chat model as context to answer our question. So let's make a loop. Okay, let's run it. Index name. Okay, interesting. Stated as a question, it seems that it had problems in the similarity search with the vector store. And if I just put the term semantic principles in, then it retrieved the... Okay, let's try something else. Okay, this worked. Also, maybe it could be specific to the FICE vector store because it's really fast, but you lose some precision. So maybe that's specific for this vector store. With another vector store, this question might have worked. I mean, I actually tested it with the Movers vector database. There it worked, so might be the case of the precision loss here. I just want to mention that it probably is not because of the 10% precision loss. When I tried it with the Movers database, I actually used the OpenAI embeddings. So there wasn't a problem of the chunk size. Okay, let's add another document. Simply by add documents, we would have to load and chunk it up, and then we can store it. Let's add a new document. I want to add this Cybersecurity International ISO standard, 26 pages, and put it in the new document directory. Let's make a new file. Or actually, we can make a utils file. Put the load documents in the utils file. So we want to load the database again.
Then just database add documents, load documents from a new document.
We also need the embedding function again. Let's try it. Okay, now it should be saved. Let's try the document chat again.
What is the ISO 27001 security standard?
Third for information security systems. But here again, the problem, to add a new document, we have to load the database, store the database again, and then reload the chat model. That's a disadvantage of the vector store. If you would have the vector database, we could do it in real time. Okay, let's wrap this in a class, and then we're going to make the Telegram chatbot.
Vision on.
So in Telegram, we want to go to the bot father, make a new bot.
Document, UNA, Frank document, bot.
Okay, there you get your API token. We're just going to the Python Telegram bot, your first bot. And basically just use everything that's stated here. I'm just going to make it fast. We defined our Q&A retrieval bot as a class. So we're just going to import it and create it. Here is just the basics from the tutorial. We defined the generate answer function, which just calls the answer question function from the bot. Yeah, we have to build a Telegram application, give it a token. We have to create a start handler. If you type in /start will start. In our case, it will post the text, I'm a bot, please talk to me. And the message handler, it's going to filter out the text, which are not commands. The command would be this /start. The handle message function, which will get the message we posted in the chat and will generate the answer, which basically just our chatbot retrieval. Then it's going to send the answer back to us. I have to add those handlers, the message handler and the start handler, and then call run polling. Let's run it. There it is. I had a PDF file on a journaling method called the metascript method in there. Let's just make a question about that. What is the metascript method? Okay, interesting. The question stated another way works. You could run it on a Raspberry Pi maybe, or a server. What are the advantages of this method? So let's say you have to read the document for work, a 100 page PDF document, but you slept it and now your meeting is coming up. Well, now you have your Telegram bot. Now in the meeting you can ask the bot
how to comply with the ISO security requirements.
Damn, and there we have it. So this concludes our session today. I hope you liked it. So again, with the vector store, you can easily store large amounts of documents, query them really fast and get the current information, add new documents, have everything you need right there. I'm going to link the resources and the code in the description. You can download this repository from GitHub and play around with it if you want. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked this video. Let me know in the comments if you want to see anything else, if I can help you, if I can make a tutorial on anything else. Hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and see you in another video.